Anybody with a neck injury. If you think, oh, they hurt their neck, car accident, bumped their head, fell off their ATV, fell off their big wheel, and they have neck pain, then this poor panda, look at him, he's hanging by his neck. What are the indications to do a C-spine workup? Panda is a mnemonic, okay? Do they have pain in their neck? If they hit their head and they have neck pain, you just do a chest, you do a neck x-ray. If they have alcohol on board, you do a neck injury. Someone who's drunk and falls in a bar and comes in drunk, you better put a collar on them and x-ray them. Studies show alcoholics can have broken necks and not know it. Here's a question for you. You got someone who's highly intoxicated, and sometimes they drive their car, and sometimes they crash, and sometimes they come into the ER, and sometimes they're not too happy about being in the ER. And I've had people who've been highly intoxicated say some very mean things about me and my mother and my family and my genetic upbringing, and that always, so you're thinking about it. That's very tough to take sometimes. And they say, I'm not keeping this collar on. What do we do? So someone who says, I'm taking this collar off and you can't stop me. Who's got a right to consent to their own health care? What did Justice Cardozo say gives you the right to have consent to make your own health care? You have to be of adult years and of what? Sound mind. And if you are not of sound mind, you cannot make decisions, okay? And this guy, oh, you can't make me keep my collar on. Oh, yes, I can. Oh, yeah, I will paralyze you and intubate you so fast. I heard of one belligerent drunk who was trying to fight the board. ER doc sutured their earlobes to the backboard. Want to play around? Okay, you can't move now, can you? I guess you can't. Okay, why did you do that? Because I felt it was the patient's best interest. There was a lawsuit of the guy who came in, I'm not keeping my collar on. Took his collar off, stormed out, became a quad. And trust me, that quad comes into the court, and they see this jury, well, we couldn't control him because he was drunk. The jury's going to say, you should have controlled him. That's your job. You have a right. I have a right to paralyze somebody for their own protection. Okay. If they have a neuro deficit, you can have a bad spinal cord injury and not see radiographic evidence. So if someone said their legs went numb, neurological deficit, they get a C-spine workup. If they have altered mental status, the demented person who falls at the nursing home and comes in, they deserve C-spine films. Lastly, if they have a distracting injury, I had a young girl who got launched off of an ATV and she had a proximal humerus fracture. And I'm like, ooh, just, okay, the EMS came to pick her up. And this was, I was a relatively younger provider. And they came in and says, oh, did you do neck x-rays? I'm like, no, no, it's just her humerus, not even her neck. And we transferred her out as a humerus fracture and that's all she was. There was no neck injury, but I made a mistake on that one. Okay, this was considered a distracting injury. People can have a severe injury in one part of their body and not think about their neck. So if you have someone who you think, boy, it's distracting them from their neck, image or C-spine, it could be a pregnant woman who is so concerned about their baby, they're not thinking of their neck. Anybody with panda, work up their C-spine.